The Crying Moon, written and illustrated by Marvin Medley. Once upon a time, there was a moon who would cry when the days turned to nights. The moon's eyes would swell with tears, and its heart would ache, bumping so hard that the whole world would shake. Every night, the moon's tears would flood the earth. The whole animal kingdom would find high ground to escape the high waters from the moon being so down. Night after night, the moon would cry and cry with no reason why. Tears upon tears, for years and years, the moon would cry with no reason why. Until one night, the moon's tears dimmed the earth's night light. No longer did the moon shine bright. Its tears had finally taken its toll, and no longer was the moon playing its role. The more the moon cried, the more the moon's light would die, but still the moon would cry and cry with no reason why. Darkness covered the earth once the sun was done with its work. Nights got darker and darker until one night nothing could be seen. The owls could not hoo or find food, since the moon was in such a bad mood. The owls could no longer fly at night, now that the moon did not shine bright. The owls knew that if they could not hoo, then something they had to do. So the owls met with the moon. They hoped they could get the earth's night light to return soon.
Moon, has brought this great sadness upon you,
said the owls to the moon. The moon replied,
you would not understand my pain because we are not the same.
The owls then replied,
why are we not the same?
The moon responded,
we are not the same because for your sadness, you don't have the sun to blame.
Who?
Replied the owls to the moon.
With tears pouring from his eyes, the moon repeated,
we are not the same because for your sadness, you do not have the sun to blame. The sunshine will never be mine,
said the moon. Confused, the owls asked the moon,
Moon, why would the sunshine cause you to whine?
Moon, listen to what we say. Your shine gives us all hope for another day.
The sun thinks you're the best because you allow it to rest.
We could not hoo, nor do all that owls do without you.
Please, moon, dry your eyes and let the light return to earth soon.
The moon began to dry its eyes and realized that although it did not shine bright like the sun, it was still truly needed by everyone. The moon looked at how dark the night had become, and the moon knew it had its own special job to get done. In a matter of minutes, the moon began to shine like new. Everything on Earth is special in its own unique way. Birds chirp, fish swim, and lions roar. If birds did not chirp, then what would fill Earth's days with sound? If fish did not swim, then how would a man teach another man how to eat?
If lions did not roar, then who would rule the animal kingdom?
Everyone is special and plays their unique role in maintaining order in Mother Nature's house. It is only when you begin to define yourself by the bird's chirp or the lion's roar that you have begun to forget what you were put on Earth for. The moon forgot that while the trees may depend on the sun to grow deep roots, the owls still depend on the moon. To who? The end.